One fall. Introducing in the ring from the State Patrol, Sergeant Buddy Lee Harker. And his opponent from the State Hospital, weighing 384 pounds.
February 25th at WrestleWar, Jim Ross and Michael Hayes here for the NWA main event. Very bizarre man, Mike.
Well, bizarre, let's put it mildly. What amazes me is how these fans, these idiots, go nuts over a big guy whose IQ is smaller than his shoe size, plays a great song like this. The whole place, look, they're going nuts boogieing with him. Now, if they're boogieing with me and Jimmy Jam, that's understandable. But this fat idiot...
The kids certainly love this big guy. He's got teddy bears. He loves teddy bears, and he's... I want to encourage the kids to bring the teddy bears to the arena. Norman loves to collect them. I know he's got hundreds of them in his home.
Well, that's why they're jealous of him.
Or in the home, I guess.
That's why they're jealous of him. He has more toys than the kids do.
Oh, he's got a... It's like he's got the Sunday comics there. Is he reading or looking at the pictures?
I have no idea. Neither does he.
Well, when he put he and Cactus Jack together at WrestleWar on February 25th, you got a... Two very bizarre individuals, and Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker trying to start out quickly, but a big headbutt. This guy, we cannot overlook. He weighs 384.
Well, not only does he weigh 384, Jim, he is agile, especially for his size. Not to the extent of a Samoan, but I mean, the man can get up in the air, and he does move with some regular speed.
He certainly must, he's been eating well. Drop kick, can you believe that one?
I guess we have to. We've seen it right there. The only thing is, now, when you talk about him and Cactus Jack, you're not talking about a meeting of the minds there.
No, it certainly will not be any lengthy discussion. He missed that big charge to the punter. Buddy Lee Parker sends him for the ride, takes him down with that clothesline.
Well, it almost took himself down.
And the sergeant, an expelled state patrol officer, trying to work on Norman.
Charlie Lee Parker trying to do it to it.
And that's Buddy Lee Parker.
Oh, Buddy Lee, Charlie Lee, Ronnie Lee, they're all the same thing.
Great crowd here.
And there's Norman's brother, Norman Lee.
Up and over goes Buddy Lee Parker, the State Patrol. Fans still to come, the Rock and Roll Express to meet the Mod Squad. And that big six-man tag team war, the three Samoans to meet the Road Warriors and Dr. Death in our feature event on the main event here today.
Norman now, as we know, is not well versed with the rules, and he's showing it there. The only thing that bothers me about Norman's, let's say his critique, his attack, is he doesn't have any mind to it whatsoever. He has yet to go for a pinfall. He's had the guy in trouble three times.
Well, he's used his head a couple of times, but it's been a headbutt, not thinking-wise, perhaps, as he goes to the ropes for a little added momentum and drops that big leg, good Lord, right across the face of Buddy Lee Parker.
Now, see here, he's looking for fan approval, as if to see, did he do the right thing? When you're an accomplished wrestler, you don't need to ask anybody. You know when you execute a fine maneuver.
Buddy Lee Parker wrecking the eyes of good old Norman. The kids love this big guy. I got a letter from a little fan that said Norman makes a great Santa Claus. Sunset flip. Uh-oh. Oh, good night. Say good night, Sergeant.
The winner of the match, Norman the Lunatic.
He'll face Cactus Jack at WrestleWar, and fans will be back with more of the main event right after this. Time out. Bye, Norman.